Hello there, everybody. My name is Demonic, and welcome back to the last video on the Merchants SMP. That's right, Merchants has been going on for about 4 months now, and, well, I'm ready to end this. Not only am I ready to end this, but the server's gonna end pretty soon, so for my last episode, I'm thinking, hey, why not give you a tour of the entire server? So, starting off right here, this is spawn. This block right here is a block where everything started. All six people who were online for the start of the server, all of us huddled on this block. Chris said, okay, we have data packs. Okay, go. And that's how Merchant Season 1 started. And that was the stupidest thing ever, dude. But right here, and I think episode 5 or 6, I don't remember, I made this sort of cyberpunk spawn tower thing, and I mean... I like it. I think it looks pretty cool. And right over here, I got bored one day, so I made a cactus farm for no reason. And apparently I also got bored one day and I planted some chorus flowers. I don't remember when I planted chorus flower. This was definitely not someone else, so that was me. So right here is where the stuff from the cactus farm goes out. This is the storage system. And right here is where originally 72, but now 48 chickens are constantly pumping out eggs. There's a bunch of eggs in here, everything's all full, and literally I got bored one day, that's why I did this. Now here, I'm thinking, why not go to the place that is, you know, closest to spawn? So this right here, this is Fennec's base. So this right here, essentially Fennec's plan was, hey, wouldn't it be cool to make like a better dirt house or whatever? And so to prove that dirt houses could be cool, I guess, he made an entire dirt village, and it looks really cool. Like, it's got some cyberpunk type aspects, I think? Steampunk? I don't know. It's got like a bunch of copper in it, and apparently these are like wires and generators and everything. It looks really cool. Windmill fields. I mean, really, this is just an amazing looking base. And around here, there's some terraforming too. Like, it's some pretty good terraforming. I don't think it's finished, but it looks pretty cool. I like those trees. Let's see, from here the closest place would be maybe Kidneystone's place, I guess. Here, why don't we go to Kidney's place, then we'll go to X-Rog's, and then we'll go to the shopping district. So this right here is Kidneystone's Island. He's going for a cyberpunk theme this season, or he is, or what, I don't really know. But, I mean, over there, you got giant clock tower. It's, like, really cool. The gears, I think the gears took hours to make. He's got some, whoa, wait. He's got some diggers as well. Jeez, this is, overall, this entire base he's made, it looks awesome. Like, Kidney is such a good builder. Over here, he's got a starter house, which I have stolen things from many a time. This is, like, a new thing he's made recently. It's, like, it's a factory, and inside it, he's got a super smelter and a bamboo farm. And this right here is what I believe. Yeah, this is like a pier or something. This is like a boardwalk pier. Got a bunch of stalls. This is like a fisher thing. I don't know, but yeah, he built this a little while back. This is also really cool. He's got like pipes with water coming out, and he's used blocks for the water. This is awesome. So next up, we're going over to X-Rog's place, which is over here. Now, X-Rog hasn't done a lot this season. He's been busy with some stuff, but here, let's go from this is south to north, which, okay, that's kind of weird, but this right here, X-Rog is the man who runs the wood shop, and well, he was kind of slow at getting wood for the wood shop, so I made a tree farm for him, and this tree farm has gotten great use from him, and a lot from me. I also use this tree farm a lot. A bunch of storage over here, some farms, beacon. I sold him those beacons. He's got, like, a skeleton farm over there, I think. And then early in the season, X-Rog's just dug a massive hole for some reason, and he grew trees in here until the tree farm was made, so yeah, I mean, it's a big hole. Let's see, the next place, this is, yeah, why not? This is the shopping district, here. So over here, this is the newest shop on the server, I believe. This is my shop. This right here is this is Piggy Farms. Essentially, I made a piglin bartering farm and a gold farm and everything. So in here is most of the items that that the piglins barter. I didn't get some of them because there were already other shops for them. But anyway, coming over here, this is where like the main shopping district area is. That right there is Chris's Prismarine Farm. He sells sea lanterns too. I've gotten quite a lot of use out of that shop. It's just a lot of use out of that shop, dude. The dark prismarine, the regular prismarine, everything. This right here is my guardian farm. The guardian farm. Gunpowder shop. Gee, I'm messing up my words right now. But the gunpowder shop has gotten like zero sales ever, so that's just lovely. This is the bone shop. I've gotten quite a few sales of bone blocks in the bone shop. Not regular bones, so for some reason. People just want their bone blocks. That is a trident shop I made. That isn't really getting a lot of use at all. Like, it's pretty cheap, too. 5 diamonds per trident. Like, come on, man. I don't think anyone has bought a trident from my trident shop, unfortunately. But in here, and this wither skeleton skull, there's wither skeleton skulls and beacons. This right here is my amethyst shop, which it's lit up, like, completely okay. No mob spawn in here. Just from the amethyst clusters or shards or whatever. I made this at the start of the season, and I was thinking to myself, this is going to be such a good shop. This is going to sell so much stuff, and it sold, like, nothing throughout the entire season. This is Timmy House. Originally, Timmy House was a prank I did on Chris that I put next to his base. I just put this next to his base, and it's Timmy House. I moved it to Kidney's place, and now his house has been sitting in the shopping district for a while. This is Fennec's lichen shop, which has nothing in it. This is Chris's iron shop, which has a lot of stuff in it. 32 blocks of iron, not diamonds. 30 blocks of diamonds for one iron. One diamond for 32 blocks is a really good price for iron. This is the vine shop that is mine. It was originally Chris's, but Chris sold it to me. Over here, this is the spleef minigame I made on stream a while back. It's cool. Pretty much you come in here with someone else, you mine all the basalt, you spleef them down, and then you and the rest of the basalt goes up a water stream up to here. So this is how I've been getting basalt for a long time, and it's a fun mini game as well. This is the Rocket Emporium. I used to have a rocket shop up in the sky over here, but I took it down, and in place of it is the Rocket Emporium. I needed more room to put stock in. And, well, there's a lot more room for stock in the Rocket Emporium. Right over there, that is, firstly, the Nether Portal. And that is Kidney's Redstone Shop. I almost said Kidney's Iron Shop. My brain is not braining. But, yeah, Kidney sells a bunch of redstone stuff in there. Egg. And that's the Chicken Mosh Pit. We don't talk about the Chicken Mosh Pit. Just like how we don't talk about Fight Club, right? Rule 1 of Fight Club. And here, this is X-Rog's wood shop. Right, he's the woodman. He's been cutting down wood and he's putting wood in the wood shop. And yeah, it's not very well stocked at all, but it's understandable. X-Rogs has been gone for a long time. And this is Bubble or Mine, or I'm still very confused about it, but this is Don't Tell Demonique, or as an American would say, Don't Tell Demonique, or Don't Tell Demonic. That's Don't Tell Demonic. I don't really remember how it's spelled exactly, but pretty much, yeah, this is Bubble's real estate office that he used to buy, like, all of my stuff or something. I don't really remember, but apparently I don't own any of my stuff anymore. And right here, this is, actually, is this getting worked on right now? No, it is not. But, this is Fennec's, courthouse, where apparently he'll be suing me. I don't know what's happening with that, but maybe this will become a video, or it'll become, I don't know, just something cool. I'm not sure. Here, let's save my base for last. We've seen my base a lot. But here we go. There's a base right here. This entire season, I've had a neighbor this whole time, and she just hasn't been really active. This is the home of Nia Kiri, or aka Kira. She hasn't been active too much, but for like the 10 total hours of playtime she has on this server, like, her stuff looks pretty good. Like, this is a pretty nice tree. It's a pretty nice house. It's a pretty nice hole into the pit of despair. And, you know, one day, I think she logged on when it was, like, 2 a.m. for us because, like, well, she's Australian. And she just built this and logged off and didn't tell anyone about it. Like, I have no idea when this happened. And then let's see, like the last place we're gonna go before my base is Chris's place over here. Now, Chris recently did some terraforming and some big old trees, which I don't know if they've been made into a video yet. I've seen a little bit of this. His trees are amazing, dude. Oh, jeez. Yeah, these trees are looking awesome. Apparently, this is like an oak tree with a big old tire swing. I can't get in the tire swing. Guys, I can't get in the tire swing. But Chris's whole thing for this season was like a fantasy sort of style. This was his starter house right here. He's got some fun stuff here. Like, his starter house is amazing. Like, in the back, he's got his doggo and a little bit of a braai going on. That's South African for campfire, I think. This is a braai. A braai, if you will. I don't know how to say it right. But, yeah. This is his starter area, his starter base over here. He made an entire new house for his storage room and everything, which also looks amazing. Chris is such an amazing builder, and you'll see even more of that right here. Chris wanted to make an entrance to his mine and just make a mine. That's what this is. This entire thing over here is just an entrance for his mine right here. He made an entire storage room for all of his mine stuff, and this is his mine. He made an entire giant thing that is so amazing. Chris is by far the best builder on here. I'm so impressed. He made all of this stuff, too. I don't even know what any of this is, but it looks amazing. But, yeah, Chris's place is just amazing. His builds are so good. Chris, if you're watching this video, your builds are so amazing. We need to get in a call sometime. You gotta teach me things. You must teach me things, Mr. Lags-a-Lot. So, that brings us to the final base on the server. So, let's just start where it all began. This right here is my starter base. This is my village. This right here, this is, oh, well, there's stone in there now. But anyway, this is my starter house. And yeah, overall, I'm very happy with how the starter house is looking. It's just awesome. Amazing starter house right here. My villagers are down there. Fennec owns this now because he bought stuff from Bubble. Apparently, he's just filling it with dirt for some reason. But my villagers are down there. This is a giant lighthouse I made pretty early on. Just some the boulders and everything. I love the ambiance of this place. This is where I have my guardian, not my guardian, my drowned farm from like weird redstone stuff. And I also have a mob farm down here I built with X-Rogs. Right around the corner over here is a wood yard, wood place, lumber yard, whatever. This is like a lumber yard type thing. And this is one of my favorite spots in the cottagecore area of my base. It just looks awesome. And right next to it, this doesn't really match up with the rest of the cottagecore base area and everything, but it's one of my favorite spots. You see, the whole real point of this is that there's a lot of imports and exports and everything going around this entire village and base area and everything, right? So, of course, you gotta have, like, I fell. So, you gotta have a pier where you get all your imports and exports and everything from. So, yeah, that's what this is. And then, I don't know if this made it in... This got made into a video, I don't think it was, but Chris pranked me a little bit. He put a bunch of rubber ducks all around my place, and all of the water everywhere, and I saved a few. All of the others are gone now. I blew them up with dynamite. Now then, there are like a few spots around here like this. My cottagecore area is really like cut in half, kinda. There's like two different types of buildings. There's like the nice stuff with the birch and the sandstone and the oak logs like this. This is my nether portal room, by the way. Oh, bunk beds. But there's this half, and then it's more like a forest half. Like, it's got a lot of forest and everything. And then there's the other half that's more like poor people and farming. So as you can see over here, potato field, lilac field, carrot field, wheat field, another carrot field, a bunch of potatoes. Just, you know, just fields and everything, farming. Windmill right there. A silo right there. The farmer's house. Farmer lives there. It's his house. And this is my barn. And inside my barn, there's bacon and syrup and waffles. And over here used to be my pig, Reuben. At the start of the server, I said that I wanted to start using pigs to travel everywhere. Because horses horses started getting attention in like Hermitcraft and whatever, and they started getting used more. And I thought, wait, but you can also ride pigs too, though. So my original plan was riding around a pig all the time, but I quickly replaced that with bacon. But then underneath the barn, I got my storage room. And I cleaned this up for you guys. I had a bunch of random shulkers all over the place, but now they're gone. I cleaned them up for you. I put them in here. But yeah, this is a manual storage room I made under my barn. And yeah, it's all manual. This is like a smelter thing. I need to get glass. But yeah, this is just a manual storage room I've had for quite a long time now. Now then, yeah, I guess that's pretty much the starter area. This, okay, I would count my base as like two areas. There's the starter area right here, this island, and you got like a little house there. That's my melon and pumpkin farm that I like never use. And this boat right here, I'll show you in like the actual survival looking through my screen things. This is just a map. But under this is where my skeleton farm is. And then, of course, you got the big boy mega area type thing. So that's like my starter place, and my mega area is over here. So walking over here and walking across this nice little bridge I built with some help from kidney stones, you enter the medieval, gothic, whatever type area of my base. Really, this is like, I call it the mega area here and the starter area over there. Really, it's all one big connected base, but there's like a big building and there's multiple small buildings. And I don't know. I just think of this as a big base and that one as a small base, even though it's just one thing. Oh yeah, and there's the boat with the skeleton farm underneath. But pretty much how it goes is this village over here on this island. It started getting a lot of attraction with trading from its imports and exports and its farming and everything. And a big old king guy said, "No, I want to control that." So the big old king guy and a bunch of his builders and royal guard all came out here, built a bunch of these houses for the royal guard and the builders and their families and everything. And while they got those houses up, they then made this giant castle, which you can't really view too well from the ground. But this is my mega castle base of doom and stuff. Here, let's just come in here. And my original plan for this place, here, I'll bring the brightness a bit up. The original plan for this place was I was going to have a bunch of mini games in here and a bunch of other stuff. And I never really got any of that done, but what I did get done is pretty cool. So right here is my throne of deep slate and everything, because that's where I'm the king guy. I'm the king that wants to control stuff. I know. Crazy. It's so crazy. I'm the king. And that is my throne. And over here, this is like a dining hall type thing. And yeah, some flying candles. I got permission from Mr. Fantasy Magic Man, Chris Lagsalot, to put candles floating in the air. He's like a magic guy. He's a wizard, so it's okay. I started getting an interior in for this spot, and then I never finished it. And I made two mini games in here, actually. This one I never played. We never did. But this is like Jeopardy, I guess. So you say, "Oh, I want member trivia for 200 points. Is it 52? And if you got it right, I'd be sitting over here and I'd be like, "Yeah, that's right. It is 52. And then you get points. But we never ended up doing that. Never ended up playing it. Maybe I'll do that at some point, but I don't know. Then there are two rooms right here and here that are just full on empty. There's nothing here. But right here, though, this is a mini game I made. Totally original. But it is inspired from a comment by Cleo105. I love saying his name. Oh, Mr. Pickles. Anyway, it's a button parkour type thing. It's like you have to get the right button and you got to find it here. For example, this is the oak button. So you go to where the oak button is, you press it, it opens up a thing. Pretty much the whole thing, you're racing another person to find the button as fast as possible, and you want to win the fastest. And the way you win is you get into the final room and then you die in lava. Yeah, that's how you win. Took me quite a few weeks to design that game. Quite a few weeks indeed. Anyway, up here on top of this staircase, if I can, this right here is what I like to think of as like the war room, where you have a guy sitting here like, "Hey, Bill, we gotta go invade Ireland or something." I don't know. Or it could also be a room where the king and his like most trusted guards and friends and everything are just sitting here and going, "We should give carrots to Romania because it would be cool. And Romanians are pretty chill." But this stained glass window is sort of the centerpiece of the castle, right? You got, it's just the centerpiece of the castle. And it really helps. It's like the eye of Sauron, in a sense. Just like a giant eye, thanks to that chandelier right there. Just a big old eye right there, front of the castle. And that is a majority of my base. I don't think, here, there's something I haven't showed off in a video yet, I don't think. But it will be pretty obvious once you see it. I didn't used to have this forest here. I built a forest off camera that I was going to put into an episode, but I never ended up doing that. And, well, it's too late now, but basically I made a giant forest around my base. It just really helped to, you know, extend the area. Because really, it was a lot bland when it was just the castle and this stuff. So, I mean, custom forest, it adds a lot. And I think that is all of the overworld so far. There are a few things in the Nether, but really a lot of it is just like portals or it's farms. Like I have a gold farm and a piglin bartering system, which you can see in another episode of mine called Piggy Farms. It was like a little while back, but in that episode called Piggy Farms, I made that stuff in a shop and whatever. And yeah, if you want to check that out, that's where you can see my cool Nether roof farms. But other than that, there isn't really a whole lot going on around here. In the overworld. Let's see. What I'm thinking here. Why not? I think I might have some stuff I need to repair. My elytra's getting pretty low. I'm gonna head over to the end. And then, yeah, I mean, I guess, yeah, we can go over there. I can show you guys what's happening in the end. There isn't a lot going on in there. And just across this bit of ocean, here we go? What's that? What is this? The entrance to the end portal is like, it's over there. Right, yeah, we fought the Ender Dragon on pigs. We had to get a bunch of pigs over here. So that's the entrance to the end portal. So I don't know what this is. What happened here? Oh, weird. What is this? Okay, well, this was not here yesterday. Like, I came here yesterday because I had some stuff to repair. I was mining a bunch of stuff. I had to repair my tool. I was just here yesterday. This was not... Yeah, that's weird.
We'll meet again. Don't know where. Don't know where.